Hey, everybody, it's Joey, and I got a hold of Michelle Simpson today, and I have her on the phone, and I just wanted to ask her some questions, and I feel that people out there would like to know a little bit more about Michelle Simpson. So, Michelle, hi, how are you?
Hi, honey.
Hi, Michelle. So let's jump right into it. Can you tell me how you first met Mr. Armstrong?
Well, I was searching on YouTube some of my favorite country songs, and I happened to stumble across his channel, and I just fell in love with his voice.
Did you know who he was before you found his channel?
No, not at all. But after watching some of his videos, and he would talk about NBC, and I would read the comments, I looked a little bit more into it. And I thought a lot of people were assholes just bringing up his past like that.
I have to ask this, Michelle, but how old are you?
I'm 33.
Michelle, how did you first come into contact with Lorne? Now, you found him by searching country videos. You enjoyed his music.
Yes.
How did you start talking to him?
Well, I would leave him comments. Well, some of the things I would say is, Lorne, when I think about you, my clit starts throbbing and my pussy gets so fucking wet. I want to feel your hard cock in me. I'd make you feel so good.
Okay. That's a normal comment you might
make. Or I'd say...
Musician?
Yeah, or I'd say, Lorne, I watch your videos when I masturbate. I hope you're okay with that. If you aren't, I'll stop. Or tried to. And he never told me not to, so I just kept doing it.
Okay. And did he respond to these comments?
He says, I'm very right. And he eventually told me to send him a personal message, in which case I did.
And what was that personal message that you sent him?
I figured out how to send my personal message, and then me, where I live.
Right, okay.
Which is none of anybody else's business, but I live in Bangor, Maine.
Really? How far is that away from Lorne?
It's about 45 minutes, and I made that 45-minute drive.
Okay, we'll get to that. We'll get to that. You sent him a private message, and then what happened?
Well, with the private messages, he then asked me to email him a picture of myself.
Okay.
So I emailed him a picture of myself.
Right.
And he thought I was very cute.
I have seen these pictures. You do look fit.
Well, thank you. Are you single, Joey?
We'll get to that later. Now.
Oh, okay.
So you guys agreed to meet?
Well, we talked for 2 days before we arranged the meeting.
Right.
Once or twice he told me we couldn't talk anymore because he has a girlfriend. And a few times he told me not to comment on his videos anymore because his girlfriend was getting jealous. So I stopped commenting on his videos. Which, by the way, it really pisses me off when a man tells me what I can and cannot do.
I agree.
I would just like to say that.
Okay. Now I need you to do something for me. I need you to tell me, from the moment you emailed him to the moment you met him at Circle K, how many days or hours was that?
It was about 2 days total.
So your relationship lasted about 48 hours, give or take?
Give or take, yeah.
Okay. And what made you record his telephone call to you?
Well, the funny thing is I wasn't aware I was recording it. I have an app on my phone that I record my work calls with because I need to keep a copy of them. And I have it set up to automatically record. And I wasn't aware of that until a couple of days later when I was going through it to send my boss some calls, and I noticed those calls were on there. And it really bothered me how he treated me, and I thought other women needed to know that he was not a good man. So I emailed Mr. Joey Jeremiah and let him know.
Ah, yeah, he's a good guy. How did Lorne make you feel in these telephone calls and these texts?
He made me feel like I owed him something, like I wasn't good enough, like I wasn't worth his time. He made me feel like a child being scolded.
Why did he scold you?
For countless reasons. Because I wasn't answering his texts quick enough, because I wasn't willing to leave my work to go drive and see him at 2 o'clock in the morning, because I was scared to meet him alone, a woman, in the middle of the night meeting a man. He couldn't handle that.
So you offered to meet him at the Circle K restaurant, and you ended up going to the Dunkin' Donuts, is that right?
Yes. But the Dunkin' Donuts and the Circle K are attached to each other.
I understand that.
But if you tell them they aren't, he will yell at you like you would not believe.
Now, he didn't show? Are you saying he didn't show to that Circle K Dunkin' Donuts?
No, I waited there, and he wasn't there. I texted him to say, I'm here, where are you? He wanted me to drive to his house.
Aha, so he changed the plans after you got there.
Yes.
Maybe he didn't have enough gas money to get up there and back.
Well, oh, that's another thing. He wouldn't buy condoms.
Did you tell him to?
Yes.
And what was his excuse for
not
buying
them? I'm not some floozy that's just going to do it raw. No rubber.
Didn't Lorne say that he was a clean?
Well, he said he hadn't had sex in over 10 years.
Now, what about his girlfriend? Didn't he say he had a girlfriend for many months?
Well, yes. He told me he's had a girlfriend for the past 3 months, but she lives out of state, and they've never met.
Aha. Okay. So he has a out-of-state girlfriend that he has never met.
Right. That he's not worried about. That he can cheat on with.
That's interesting, Michelle. So then after that, you left the Circle K, and I understand he called you, and your voice sounded slightly different?
Well, yes, I sounded a little bit different. When I get stressed and angry, my voice often changes in pitch and timbre.
So when you get upset, you get a little bit of a huskier voice, we basically call it. And he calls you, and did he shout at you? Did he yell at you?
Oh, he screamed at me. He shouted at me. He scolded me for no reason. He made me feel scared.
I heard that, and I do sympathize with you, Michelle.
Thank you.
I don't know if I have any other questions. Have you spoken to Lorne since the Circle K incident?
Yes, he's texted me since. And he's wanted to meet again. He went out and bought condoms this time.
Really? What type did he buy?
He bought ribbed.
Okay.
Well, first he wanted me to choose, but I didn't respond to him quick enough, apparently. So he chose the ribbed.
Ribbed, okay. And you never met him, though, after that?
No, I didn't.
Do you think he may have saved the receipt so he could return them?
I would hope so, because everybody knows he's not going to be using them.
And do you have anything else you would want the good people out there to know?
Well, I'm single and willing to fuck.
All right, well, we'll talk about that offline, Michelle.
Okay, thank you.
All right, Michelle, thank you very much. Everybody, thanks. That was Michelle Simpson, formerly known as Michelle Simpson-Armstrong. And thanks for listening. Bye-bye.